All right, I thought I'd shoot you a quick video just so we had a little bit better idea of what we're trying to get done here. This is the entire jet unit. I chose the model of jet ski that I scavenged this from because one, it was in excellent condition. All the bearings and everything in this are very good. Plus, this water intake isn't molded into the jet ski like a lot of newer jet skis. In fact, it's all just one piece. Well, it's not one piece, but it's all one unit. It has its own water intake and jet pump. I've got the steering, the reverse bucket, the mounting points. All of that will be incorporated into the boat, not necessarily our motor frame. It has a spindled axle coming out of it here at the end. This distance between what would be the boat bottom and about the middle of this shaft is just under 5 inches. But what that shaft does is it actually couples in to what I have here in this bag housing. This is a whole nother bearing assembly that will bolt to the face, and this would be the majority of what we would be working with as far as connecting the shaft of the Harley motor to this shaft here. I don't have the other yoke to this end, but I could. The other yoke to this end was sold with the 650 motor, but I could have another yoke in. They sell them used and they haven't changed the style much in a long time. However, my Harley motor will, either through a coupler, this coupler or a coupler of about any kind, will connect to this, what is a 1-inch shaft into this bearing housing. So really we'll be going from this 1-inch shaft to the Harley motor, and this 1-inch shaft will be feeding power to this jet pump unit.
Allow its one center to be filled full of sealant. Yeah. So it's already bored out the middle and that
it just drilled the middle, so now it just has to do the sides instead of having to make the holes. the initial hole. You make the initial hole and then the tool comes into it.
Right.
And then it
is
circular and circulates. It starts at the edge and it just spirals out till it gets to the side, and then it makes one more clean pass.
It does.
And then it's done.
Yeah.
It'll be a pretty shiny hole.
Made it home with the boat. Got it up there from the South Texas area. Got her all welded out. Ready for the motor and pump installation. And then of course we'll outfit it with all the wiring it needs. But 48 inch bottom, 12 foot long, eighth inch aluminum. Got an airboat style hole, but with a jet pump conversion. So looking forward to this build, and please like, subscribe to follow the build. There's a lot more to come. Most of it's already underway. We'll be adding more to this series. Just wanted to give you guys a good look at the hole.